Welcome back to Season 3. Now a recap of Season 2 for those who might have forgot. The great Cat Dennings died of old age. It was just terrible. She shouldn't have gone that way. She had so much life left in her. But hopefully, her future family will be just as interesting, even though her grandchildren didn't want to be filmed. So that's why it's taken so long to come back on, because it was awkward family members who don't want to be famous on YouTube. And also, we are starting to come and recover from the space virus that ravaged Mars and Earth. As you can see, it's now becoming a much calmer time, as long as you've had your vaccination. Alright? Maybe they don't agree, but you gotta have it, okay? You got to have it, otherwise we have to keep using machines to get round chores. Like taking shopping out of a car, which is very, very slow and frustrating. So please have it. Because you
want to get yourself killed.
Look how dangerous it is not having your vaccination. It's not just about you, it's about looking after others. You've got to watch out and not be selfish. Come on, people!
Congratulations,
everyone! Yeah, because getting hit by the space virus is as bad as getting hit by a lorry. Or falling down from a height on a bike. I mean, look how painful that is. Ouch! And definitely don't risk it if you haven't got a social healthcare system. Like those who have to pay a lot in America. I mean, if I had to pee, I wouldn't be doing that silly thing. Or any of this, because look how silly it is. You can break things. You can get bruises and concussions. No, thank you. No. We don't want to be doing this now. No, no. So don't try this at home. Don't try it at school. Don't try it at college. Basically, just don't do it anywhere.
You just want to get out of there and survive the whole thing. It's a very instinctive action, I think.
Congratulations, everyone! Congratulations, everyone! Be grateful! Earth survived! We survived, people!
Congratulations,
everyone! So treat it as such! I mean, look at this again! How scary! That boy is scary! He just likes blowing things up. So we need to recover completely from the virus, and people have started going out again and even going on holiday. Like, look at these tourists in Monaco. Look at them going about their business. Like, there's no virus at all. It's terrible. You've still gotta be careful, people. We don't want any new variants. We definitely don't want any viruses from space. No. Definitely not. Oh, God, I do miss the beaches and the sunshine. And the cocktails. So, I'm tempted to book a flight myself. Seeing these images. I don't know about you, but I could do with some sun. There's none here in this country. It's terrible. Even if you weren't stuck inside, it's cold. Well, but at least it wasn't as cold as space for the Dennings. It was just horrible for them in the second-hand rocket house ship. trying to survive space. Even the animal kingdom recovers and events start being set up again. So we're getting a bit closer to everything going back to normal. But will we really ever go back to normal after lockdown? So life after the space virus is finally here. And it's just something we'll have to live with. But you've got to have your vaccine. It's very important that you take care of your own health and keep washing your hands, even though the government doesn't keep reminding you. And you still need to do your tests and put your mask over your nose, you silly scientist, and keep spraying with Dettol. Yes, even this child understands the importance of hygiene. So please keep it up. I know you've been used to being inside, you're used to lockdown, but people, you're outside again and we've got noses. So you've got to shower again. You can't go around being stuffy in your pajamas all the time. Get dressed, people. And here we are, seeing the Dennings, who don't really want to be filmed anymore, the grandchildren. Destiny and Abraham. They've gone back to Earth and gone to Japan to live, thinking that we wouldn't follow them there. But as you can see, we have. And look what they're doing. They're setting fire to the house. You can't do that in Japan. The houses are made out of paper and other flammable stuff. It's like sliding paper doors and walls. Yeah, cool kids never sleep, so wake up, Abraham. You're not cool. Well, he will be now. He's out in the snow. He's going to the ski resort near his house. So that's what they're doing with Kat Dennings' money. They're not working, they're not doing anything. They're just living the high life and going skiing. Well, that is just boring. We want to see people doing stuff. Oh, wait a minute. Look, they're hopeless. They've set fire to house again. What's going on? What are you doing? Come on, get it out. Or ring the fire brigade or whatever they have in Japan. There's got to be something. Now it's inside. Come on, hurry up and sort it out. Oh no, don't die. We've had enough Dennings die. No. Oh no, another one. No. Oh good, it's all sorted out now. So the Dennings were in Japan in the previous clips. But now I've got some serious news to tell you about the Dennings. And it might really shock you. I know it has me. So please brace yourself. We'll give you a minute to sit down, make your cups of tea, and get ready for your mind to be blown. You will not believe what Abraham and Destiny are planning on doing next. It's such a shocker. But they're running away from Japan. They're literally moving from Japan. They've only just got there. So they burnt down their paper mansion. So now they have to move. So end of part one. Enjoy the commercials.
come on down to Little M's new burger joint grand opening this Saturday. Come and enjoy all the beef that you can eat. Don't forget, now everybody's going out again, check out Tourist Advisor for all the fun places you can go and all the best roller coasters, all the places to go and visit and have some fun in the great outdoors again, now that we're all free.
Welcome back to part two of the show. Now we're going to do the longly anticipated music chart. So let's get playing those tunes once again. Even though that was really, it wasn't really affected by the space virus. But here we are down from number 5. And here we are, the Singing Kitties. Featuring Little Chick.
Bye.
number three, it's the Jelly Pirate song.
Watching the sunset and recording it.
Okay. The venue.
Lion King.
Even if I. Yes. Even though I watched the film a few days ago, I can't remember the rest of the song.
No, it's the new one. It's the CGI one.
And
Melissa also picked to watch the new Jungle Book.
Can't remember the rest of the song now.
Well, that's all it is, really. Jungle Book.
Can't remember the rest of the song now.
Well, that's all it is, really. Jungle Book.
Can't remember the rest of the
song. And the number two is the Chinese Lion King.
Lion King. Melissa also picked to watch the new Jungle One.
Ranji oopsla blargs.
Isni bavoy.
Nebu fleebu zar.
New releases this week include the following.
Thank you.
Boogie. I hope you enjoyed the music, and also you've got your cups of tea and you sat down and you're ready for the absolutely shocking news that I'm about to tell you about the Dennings. And don't forget, we've had some very shocking things. So Kat Denning returns, but kind of. I mean, she's not coming back like a zombie or something. Or coming back like some alien or a robot or anything like that. But we are going to continue, finally, with the Dennings family legacy. The grandchildren did not want to be filmed, and they wouldn't allow us access. But we've got one in the family that is very, very interested. But first, the shocking movies is that they've gone from Japan and they moved to the UK. That is right, people. They've left the place that has left Europe. So the Dennings have moved to the UK. And Kat Denning's Next Generation's great-grandson is based on this season. So hear how this happens and we'll fill you in. This is Abraham Dennings and he is proposing to Sayuri Geisha, his Japanese girlfriend. So here we have these two getting together. I'm making a very cute couple, if I may add. So it's going to be very interesting to see what the new grandson is like. And here they are moving into the new stone-built house, because let's face it, they burnt down the paper house in Japan, so I'm glad they're living in a stone one. And here they are trying for the grandson in a cow shed. Yes, a cow shed. Apparently that's a UK thing. Ew, there's an actual cow outside. And then we'll follow them around the big stone house, which is very different from the paper one that they've just left. I mean, this must be very, very strange for Sayuri, who was born and bred in Japan. So here we are, her having a normal UK shower and not a traditional Japanese one. But even so, she's playful at the moment. Well, very playful. So she must be enjoying herself. At least we know it's a lot warmer here, because the place they were in Japan was very, very cold. It was covered in snow and that's why they could do a lot of skiing. But they didn't want to be on camera skiing or doing anything else. In fact, they're not even very happy about us showing this little bit. But we need to get some context here. We really, really do. So here we are, the honeymooners. I've just moved into the new house and I'm just moving into the hot tub and trying once again.
Good night. Go back.
That water is now disgusting! What have they been doing in there to get it so dirty? It's gross, it's nasty! And now they're in bed, fast asleep, so we better not disturb them. But here he is 18 years later, we can't name him yet. But this is the great-grandson of the Cat Dennings. Which you can tell because we've got the black hair and the brown eyes are still in the family. Oh, and he's got some right swagger. So he looks like he's a right character, so no wonder why he wants to become famous on YouTube. But we got to wait until he's 21. So as soon as there's 21 people, we can resume season 3. But right now, he's just a little teenager. And his parents will not allow him to be filmed until he's 21, and they think they can handle him. So here he is. Jensen James Dennings, who we can now name because now he's 21 years old. So he's very different. So let's find out more about him and what happened. And let's see if we can find out little bits from his childhood. Because we know his dad Abraham's and Destiny's wasn't very good. So the 21 year later, and he's having his birthday cake. Given to him by his auntie. And there we go. And his mum's in the other room as well. So here we go. And now the young boy has now become a man. So let's start this new generation and see what chaos may ensue or have interest. So first thing he's doing as a 21-year-old is eating chocolate cake. So is he going to be responsible? Who knows? But either way, it's going to be finally fun to see another Denning. But at least he's starting out life pretty well. Because Kat Dennings, if you remember, was homeless. And she was on a tropical island trying to survive by her wits and anything she could get her hands on and make a living. But she didn't only just do that, she didn't just survive, she thrived. And she made this family quite wealthy. So now here he is, buying a rundown dairy factory that has closed down in this little village. So hopefully, he'll have a good start in life, and we'll be fully entertained.
Some Beanie Babies new with tank from some guy I've never met in Norway. Found him on eBay. I am the type who is liable to snipe you with 2 seconds left to go. Whoa. Got PayPal or Visa, whatever'll please ya, as long as I've got the dough. I'll buy your tchotchkes, sell me your watch, please. I'll buy.
I'm highest bidder.
From that worldwide garage sale,
Dukes of Hazzard,
hey, Dukes of Hazzard.
A used pink bathrobe, a rare mint snow globe, a Smurf TV tray I bought on eBay. My house is filled with this crap, shows up in bubble wrap most every day. What I bought on eBay, tell me why.
I need another pet rock,
tell me why.
I got that Alpha alarm clock, tell me why.
I bid on Shatner's old toupee,
they had it on eBay.
I'll buy check my feedback, A++. They all say they love me on eBay. Gonna buy
a slightly damaged golf bag.
Gonna buy
some Beanie Babies new with tank from some guy
I've never met in Norway.
Type who is liable to snipe you with 2 seconds left to go. Whoa, got PayPal or Visa, whatever'll please ya, as long as I've got the dough.
I'll buy your tchotchkes, sell me your watch, please. I'll buy.
And here he is, deciding to go for an ambitious career, because we know he's ambitious. Because at the moment, he's been working at Sims Staff Stealing, making copies. So he's been a barista. But it doesn't pay very well, and it's only part-time, which was alright when he was a teenager, living with his parents, and at high school. But now, he's having to pay for this place himself. The parents have spoiled him and they bought it, but he's still got to be able to afford to run it and be independent, which should be really easy compared to how Kat Dennings started, having to live on a campsite in a tent, having to get food any way she could. But she did it. Let's see what this young gentleman is capable of doing. So hopefully, he'll get all his things from eBay, and all the other things from Amazon, and IKEA, and all the other places wherever these Sims go shopping online. I got to admit, I'm impressed with their delivery service, because it's not just next day delivery like mine. They get it instantly! And they don't even have like a delivery, it just turns up! They can just move it about, and they can decorate without having to move all the stuff and the furniture and deal with all the plastic and all the flooring and the mess and the destruction that you got to go through with your DIY. It's just nice and easy for them, it's just click, 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 and it's done. I wish it was like that here. But anyway, less about my DIY issues. Let's get back to his and his little shopping spree. Cause it must be nice. His grandma, I know I keep going on about her, but his grandma had to get things out of bins to eat. And he can just buy a ridiculously priced treadmill without even blinking. I think he's going to be spoiled. Yeah, I do. I mean, we're all rooting for Cat, but are we gonna root for this spoiled little man? Are we really? I know we don't know him yet, but the first thing he's doing is going spending. What would you do? Tell me in the comments below. Would you go on a shopping spree as soon as you left your parents' house? Or would you be sensible with your money? Or would it matter if you earned it or not? I mean, if you've earned it and you've worked for it, would you think about how you're spending it a bit more rather than it just being given? Give this a lot of thought. But please let me know. Because we're at the moment, all we're doing is seeing him go shopping. And I thought he wanted to be a famous YouTuber. But all we're doing is seeing him go shopping.